Hey, what's up, YouTubers? And welcome back to another Toddy Walnuts update video. Today I have a stack of some classic shot on video low budget films. This is a complete series, and I'm gonna get into that and tell you guys about an upcoming release. I got some Vinegar Syndrome titles that are going out of print for the slipcover. I have some Disney Movie Club exclusives I'll get into. I have a couple of Westerns in that pile, a couple of Scream Factory Steelbooks. I picked up a latest title from 88 Films. And I have a very rare and hard to find Masters of the Universe box set figure. And that is a hot ticket right now at the moment, so I will show that last. But stick around, get yourself comfortable. Get a beverage and a snack, and let's get into the collection update. So the first stack we'll get into here is the Camp Blood series, and these first two I owned already. This was called Camp Blood. It's a flipper disc because it also does come with the 3D version of the film. I did get a new blanket too, and they're kind of I'll show that last, I guess, the blanket too, but they're trying to get comfortable here. But these are super low budget films, but they're pretty fun. I always do enjoy these type of films. And I only had the first two, like I mentioned. Like I said, it's a flipper disc. And then you get the insert with the chapter stops right there. So that's pretty cool. But I had Camp Blood 2. I put these in white cases, by the way. This was a former rental. You can see that little sticker there on the top. It says it was from Video Fox. But a couple weeks ago, I went onto a website called oldies.com, right there, oldies.com. And I picked up a bunch of these. I didn't even know there was this many sequels to the film, but this is actually part three, and it's called Within the Woods. I have not watched these yet, but I grabbed them. Just wanted to share these with you guys and let you know about oldies.com. Maybe some of you have gone there before. I've gone there many times before. They do have some pretty good deals over there. But I think I was getting these for like about 10 bucks a piece or less. Of course, these are DVDs. Here's Camp Blood 4. Shoestring budget horror. And most of these films have a charm to them with, you know, subpar acting. Some of the kills are usually pretty lame, but I'm a sucker for these kind of movies, and you know, I don't mind grabbing these and picking these up. But the reason I'm showing you all of these now in this video is because there is a Blu-ray box set that I recently picked up, or I should say I recently ordered it. It didn't arrive yet. But once that comes in the mail, and it should be here sometime next week, I will do an update video on that as well. But the DVD stopped at number 6 for the sequels. But I think the Blu-ray box set goes up to like 10 or 11. So that's pretty cool. I'm looking forward to grabbing that. But I'm going to do a quick little recap here. You guys let me know if you watched any of these. I kind of have a soft spot for these first two. These are pretty old. These came out about 10 or 12 years ago, I think. Actually 19 years ago now. 2002 this came out. But you guys let me know if you've seen any of these and if you know anything about the Blu-ray box set. So let's go on to the next pile. So this next little pile here are three titles that are going very low on quantity. They're going out of print on the Vinegar Syndrome website. And the first two have slipcovers. The third one was never issued with a slipcover. But I will get to that in a minute. first one is called They Were Best Friends Until, I think it's just called Best Friends, actually. Yeah. Best Friends, I don't know anything about the movie. I was aware of this on their website. I wasn't really going to pick this one up, but I figured since it's low on quantity for the slipcover, and these always go up in price, and if I don't like it, I can always flip it. But I think this is kind of a rape revenge type film. I could be wrong about that. Maybe one of you guys can chime in below and let me know. But it is a restored 2K scan of the movie. There's some making friends interviews, video conference interviews, some good stuff on there. It's a film from 1974, and it is all region. There is the disc art. And there's the reversible cover, which is exactly like the slipcover. So I kind of like this cover a little bit better. It has kind of a more 70s vibe to it. And there's nothing wrong with this cover at all. It looks great. But I would have preferred that one on the slipcover, and maybe could have switched that out. I don't know. But that is Best Friends. The next one was one of their earliest releases. This was way, way back before they even had slipcovers, before slipcovers were even thought of by Vinegar Syndrome. This was one of their earliest releases. And I never picked it up because it didn't really sound like it was something that was on my radar, to be honest with you. It's a movie from 1971. It's a Blu-ray DVD combo. The movie is in black and white. And it says it's a major forgotten work from New York's underground film scene from the late 60s, early 70s. The telephone book tells the story of Alice, a sex-obsessed hippie who falls in love with the world's greatest obscene phone caller. So who knows, it may be good, you know. But they have recently released it with the slipcover. And this was one of the deals where this was released without a slip, and then I think about a year ago or so they issued it with a slip. So, but now these are almost sold out. So if you guys are on the fence about this movie and you're not really sure if it's your style or your thing, you could always pick it up and with the slipcover now, and if you don't like it, you can flip it and get your money back. It's not a big deal. But if anybody has any comments about this, I'd be interested to hear what your take was on the movie. So go ahead and leave a comment below. And finally, this was released without a slip. Who knows if someday they may release it with a slip cover. This was strictly limited to 3,000 copies. I think they're only down to a couple hundred. And that was a couple weeks ago, so it may be less than that by now. But I wanted to grab it. It's called Trip with the Teacher. And I think this is kind of one of those sexploitation type films. It is all region. It is a Blu-ray DVD combo. Another film from 1974. Another restored 2K scan, commentary tracks, interviews, really good stuff. And it says, Miss Tenney and a group of summer school students are on a camping trip in the desert to study ancient native cultures and a hike through the Grand Canyon. Everything sounds great so far, right? But when their bus breaks down in the middle of nowhere, a trio of bikers led by the demented Al finds them and tricks them into heading out into an abandoned farmhouse. So maybe it's not too bad. I'll have to pop that in and check it out. I always like the demented redneck type movies. So that is Trip with the Teacher, and these are the three that I picked up from Vinegar Syndrome recently. All of these had less than a couple hundred copies left. I think this was the one most in danger of going out of print first or being sold out first. And these had a couple hundred left at the time. They might be less than that. So if you want to check those out, go to Vinegar Syndrome and get you a copy of it. Now this next pile is, these are Disney exclusive, Disney website exclusive releases. And you can only get these through the Disney Movie Club online. And I've been buying a lot of exclusive lately. I'm trying to get them all. There's a really big sale going on right now if you are a member, because this is their 20th year in business with the Disney Movie Club. And you know, these are like gold. I think eventually, once these are out of print and these are only exclusives, you can only get these online, I think these are going to be worth their weight in gold. So I plan on doing a video, and I may even do that tonight. So I may start recording that after this video. I'm going to go through and show you guys all of the exclusives that I own so far. I do have a couple more coming, and I'm going to place an order for one more. I think I'm going to try to get them all or close to them all. I'm not exactly sure. But anyway, this was a suggestion from a fellow YouTuber friend here on, I can't remember who it was, I think it was Dave, suggested that I get the Scarecrow of Romney Marsh, which was, the original title was called Dr. Sin, and this was one of the Walt Disney treasure tins at one time. And it was very limited, and it was very rare, hard to find. And I think that tin was going for like $200, $250, even up to $300 sometimes. And that was only on DVD with the collectible tin, but this is the Blu-ray. This is a Disney exclusive. It looks really cool. I have not watched it yet. But I picked this up on the Disney Movie Club, and I think it was about $12. So I will take that all day long. So if you guys are interested in Disney Movie Club exclusives, stay tuned for the next video, and I'll be showing that. I picked up two of these. This is the latest release from Disney Movie Club, and is the latest Movie Club exclusive. This is a 6-disc set called The Best of Mickey. You get two Blu-rays, you get 3 Blu-rays and 3 DVDs, and then you also get a digital code. And they're calling it The Best of Mickey. You get Fantasia, Fantasia 2000, and Celebrating Mickey, and there's the Movie Club exclusive. So these are going for $35 retail, but if you are a member of the Disney Movie Club, I think you get it a pretty good discount. I think it comes out to like $25 or something like that. This one is still sealed. I picked up two just to have one for a rainy day or to trade sometime down the road. This is the one I'm going to view. This one I did open up already. So we can take a look at the inside of that. But first of all, this slipcover is beautiful. It has kind of that foil metallic shiny look to it. It's beautiful. It's pretty sturdy. It feels thick. This whole set is very heavy. A 6-disc set usually is very heavy, but this is a really nice solid set. It feels really good. So I took the digital code out already. I'm not going to give that away. There is the Blu-ray for Fantasia. There's the Blu-ray for Fantasia 2000. And there is the Blu-ray for Celebrating Mickey. And then you get the DVDs for the same movies. Fantasia 2000 and Celebrating Mickey. So you get 6 discs plus the digital code, which is a beautiful set. It's a really, even $35 would be a great deal. But this is one of those kind of sets that once this goes out of print, I think you're going to see this for $100, $150, easy. So that's why I grabbed two. And I suggest you guys grab one while you can. And then the last one for this video is 101 Dalmatians Part 2. This is a Movie Club exclusive. I have not opened it yet, but it comes with a nice slipcover. And then there's the movie. So these are the Disney Movie Club exclusives I picked up for this update video. You guys let me know if you had a chance to pick these up, if you didn't get this, if you're planning on getting it, which I would really recommend you do that. It's a beautiful set. Probably one of the better sets I've seen in a long time. I think this is probably right up there with some of those 3D Blu-ray, you know, with the lenticular cover sets that they had. This is right up there with that. So maybe even a little bit better for this. Anyway, let's move on to the little Western section I have. Okay, so here we're getting into my Western couple pickups I got over the last couple weeks. This first one here is the movie conclusion of one of the greatest television series in history, in my opinion. In fact, I think it's number 2 only to The Sopranos, for me, in my opinion again. But this is Deadwood, the movie. And season 3, whether you want to call it canceled or it didn't continue after season 3, and they kind of left it with a cliffhanger. This is the movie that kind of wraps up the series. I still haven't watched it yet. But this movie came out several years. I think it was like 15 or maybe even 20 years after the show ended. So everybody is much older, obviously. And some of the actors have passed away. Like Powers Booth, he was a big part of the show. I'm wondering how they're going to wrap up that part of the movie. But this movie came out in 2019, so it has been out for about a year and a half already. But almost everybody came back. So I'm definitely looking forward to checking that out. And in fact, I've been contemplating even going back and rewatching the series again from the beginning. That's how good it was. It was really good. Based on true events, Deadwood. If any of you guys have watched this, and you can let us know what you thought about it in the comments without any spoilers. I'd be interested to hear your take on the movie and how the series concluded. So give me a thumbs up on that if you liked it. Just go down in the comment section and let me know if you liked it or not. And if not, why? And then here's another movie here that this probably has the most releases for a Western. I think it already has about 5 or 6 Blu-ray releases. Kino Lorber, since I'm on their mailing list, their emailing list, they push me emails every once in a while, let me know things are coming out, if I want to pre-order. So a couple of months ago, they sent me an email about The Good, the Bad, and the Ugly, that they were releasing on 4K and Blu-ray. So I thought I'll go ahead and pick it up, but I can guarantee you this is going to be the very last time I ever buy this movie. I think the movie's great. I love the movie. I don't need to keep buying it over and over and over again. So I brought out another copy of it, which Kino Lorber released the same edition about a year or two ago. And this was the 2-disc edition. We'll get into that in a minute. It was 2 Blu-rays because they had the extended cut here on Blu-ray, and they had the theatrical cut here on Blu-ray. So I was very happy with this edition. I didn't need to get it again, but now we have the 4K here, and I have not even opened it yet. We'll open it here together on the channel, and we'll compare this edition with the last edition and see if it's worth the repurchase of it. So this one comes with a slipcover. The other one didn't. Slipcover is pretty cool, actually. It's a very solid. There's no hole. You can see in the back, they actually put the barcode on the bottom. So very, very well done on that. Good to you, Kino Lorber, for doing that. Slipcover is pretty thick. It's a good quality slipcover. Pretty impressed with that already. So you have the... Okay, let's go side by side just from the beginning. The one on the left in the black case is the 4K, and the one on the right is the 1080p, just the Blu-ray edition of it. So it's pretty much the same already, other than the black case and the blue case. You open it up, and you have The Good, the Bad, and the Ugly on 4K, and you have The Good, the Bad, and the Ugly on Blu-ray. So we have to find out if this one has both editions of the film, which I don't see that listed here. For special features, you get audio commentary with Tim Lucas. He's always very good. Always enjoy Tim Lucas's work. You get a making of documentary. You get Il Maestro, Ennio Morricone, parts 1 and 2. You get the Leone style on Sergio Leone featurette. So you got some pretty good special features on here. The Man Who Lost the Civil War documentary, and Reconstruction, deleted scenes, vignettes, and much more, but it doesn't say anything about the 2 different versions of the film. Let's go to the back of this one. You get 3 different audio commentaries on this one. Let's see. You get the making of doc on here. You get the Leone style featurette on here as well, and you get the Il Maestro featurette on here as well. The Man Who Lost the Civil War, same thing. Reconstruction of The Good, the Bad, and the Ugly, deleted scene. So all of the special features seem to be the same. Only this one has 2 different cuts of the film, and this one has the 4K cut of the film. So I guess it's up to you how you want to have it, if you want to have it both like I do, or if you're kind of on a budget and you only want to have one, or maybe you're not on a budget, but you just don't like collecting doubles. I'm not sure what to tell you. That's up to you. If you want to have, you know, do you want to have the 4K edition of it, or do you want to have two different cuts of the film? That's up to you. But let's move on to the next pile here. I picked up a couple of more Steelbooks from Scream Factory, and this one I bought used on eBay. And this is The Howling. I put it in a case already. I bought it used. I think these are going for around $50 to $60 sealed, and I didn't really need to have it sealed. I think I got this one for $24 used, and it's in perfect condition. So I will take that. I'm going back and trying to collect all of the Steelbooks. There's some I'm missing, and the ones I am missing are the big buck pieces. Like some of them are really expensive. And I think I'm going to record a third video tonight. I'm going to show you guys, it'll be a short one. I'm going to show you guys all of the Steelbooks I have so far. And that's, I think I have like maybe 15 or 16 of them. I think they released about 20-ish, 25 maybe. I think it's less than 25. Somewhere between 20 and 25 they released so far. And then there's another one for pre-order, which I did pre-order. I think it's Battle Beyond the Stars. So I picked that one up on eBay, used, and I got this one from Scream Factory, still sealed. They still had some copies of this available on their website, which is funny because I think I paid $30 for this on the website. But if you go on eBay, people are selling this for $50, $60. So you might as well just buy it directly from Scream Factory. These damn scalpers, man, they gotta ruin everything. But I sounded a little salty because I really hate scalpers. But those are the two Scream Factory Steelbooks I picked up. So let me show you guys the 88 films collection I picked up. So recently I picked up a collection, a horror movie series collection. This is the I Know What You Did Last Summer trilogy from 88 films. Comes with this beautiful slipcover. Really like it. I never owned these movies on DVD or in any format, and I figured this would probably be a great way to get it and own all three of them. So this was a cool little trilogy. This is one of those teen horror type films with Freddie Prinze is in here, and I forget her name, the blonde. Anyway, let me see if I can find that on here. Jennifer Love Hewitt, Sarah Michelle Gellar is who I was thinking of. Ryan Phillippe, Freddie Prinze Jr. I'm usually not the biggest fan of those particular actors or these type of films. But like I said, I didn't own these before. And I might as well get them in the collection and get them all in one Blu-ray set. And this looks pretty cool, I'll be honest with you. There's the first one. There's the blonde I was thinking of. She's gorgeous. All the girls in this series, Jennifer Love Hewitt was gorgeous. I Still Know What You Did Last Summer, and I'll Always Know What You Did Last Summer. Not really much else to say about that. I think it's a cool little set, and I would recommend picking it up. If you don't own any of these, or even if you do and you like the series, this would probably be a nice little upgrade for you. So let's move on to the figure that I picked up, and I'll tell you guys a little bit about that. Then I'll show you guys my latest quilt, and we will wrap this up. Okay, so the last item in this update video is a box set of two of the villains from the Masters of the Universe franchise. They're calling this one Rise of Evil, the Dark Origins of Two of Eternia's Evil Warriors, and that is Keldor on the left and Cronus on the right. And that is actually Skeletor. His name was Keldor before he was turned into Skeletor. And just to give you guys kind of a quick history of how Keldor turned into Skeletor, and depending on which part of the franchise you follow, the canon and the lore doesn't add up between the 1980s Masters of the Universe and the 2002 revival. They're both excellent shows, but they don't follow the same canon, which means in the early Masters of the Universe from the 80s, Skeletor was a evil spirit from another dimension, and he was He-Man's nemesis. In the 2002 revival, he was the king's brother who turned bad, and therefore he was Prince Adam's nemesis, and it was actually his uncle. So Skeletor is actually He-Man's uncle in the Revival series. And Keldor tried to assassinate the king by splashing a vial of acid on the king. But the king threw up his shield, and the acid hit the shield and splashed back and got Skeletor on the face, and it deteriorated his face pretty bad. And he had to get help from an evil sorceress, and that's what they came up with. They couldn't fix his face, so he had to have a skull head, a skull face, whatever you want to call it. And Cronus is actually Trapjaw. And that's what he looks like before he turned into a cyborg. And you guys know Trapjaw. He ends up getting that big kind of a bear trap swivel hinge on his jaw. And he has I guess he loses his right arm, and in his place of his right arm, he has a kind of a fixture where he can add different weapons. But these are the two originals. This one is very hard to find. This was new for 21. It just came out like a week ago. Last week it came out. And it's a Target exclusive, like I said. And they're only getting two copies of this per store. And that's it. They come two into a box. And these are already going for over $300 a piece online. I got mine on, let's see, what day did I get this? On April 23rd last week, I picked this up. Got it for $29. So I did actually get this at the store. I would never pay $200 for this, but there are people that are going crazy trying to get this. And I think actually $200 is probably low for this. They're probably going more than that. So I think this is a really, really cool set. I think it's definitely worthy of owning. And I think people are going crazy for it, not only because it's a Target exclusive and because it's rare, but because these two characters have never been released in any form before in a figure. And then you can take that's the Skeletor head. You can actually remove Keldor's head and put Skeletor's head on that body if you want to. So these are some of the other characters that are coming out in 2021. I have my eyes set on that Panther, so you'll probably see that in an update video. I like to collect the villains, so this is what Keldor looks like when you remove his head and put the Skeletor head on there. Really, really nice artwork, though. Check that out. Let's see if we can name some of these. We got Beast Man. And we got Keldor, a.k.a. Skeletor. We got Trapjaw, a.k.a. Cronus. Triclops. Merman. What was her name? Evil Lynn was her name, right? And then there's the king, who is Prince Adam's father. That was He-Man's father right there. Stratos, right? I could be wrong about that one. There's Man-at-Arms, who was He-Man's right-hand man. So this is really cool. Not only is it a piece of my childhood, but it's a very cool collectible. And I am an in-package collector, so I'll never... You know, this one didn't even go on the shelf. You can see that it still has the little tag still in that hole there. Because when I got to the Target store, I went online. You can't buy these online. You have to go get them in the store. And I saw that at my location there was one left, so I drove down there, and it wasn't on the shelf. And I had to talk to a lady, and she said, she looked in her computer, and she ended up going to the back, and she came out carrying this one. It was like, oh, I was so happy. So, and I saw that there was a bunch of other guys kind of swarming around the toy section, so I think a lot of people are looking for this. So I just got lucky. I was in the right place at the right time. I went home with this. But there are a lot of upset people who are looking for this who can't find it. So anyway, let me pause it here. I'll do a recap, and then I'll get my dogs off the bed and show you guys my new quilt, and we will wrap this up. Okay, so for Vinegar Syndrome, some of the rare titles, or not rare, but the titles that are going out of print very soon are Best Friends, The Telephone Book, and Trip with the Teacher. So if you guys are interested in any of those, even if you're maybe interested, I would go ahead and just grab them now while you can. Picked up a couple of Westerns. I got Deadwood the movie, and I got The Good, the Bad, and the Ugly on 4K from Kino Lorber. This one I had already. I got I Know What You Did Last Summer trilogy, a couple of Steelbooks from Scream Factory. I got Motel Hell and The Howling, and some Disney exclusives, The Scarecrow of Romney Marsh, also known as Dr. Sin. I got The Best of Mickey, Fantasia, Fantasia 2000, and Celebrating Mickey. And 101 Dalmatians Part 2, Patch's London Adventure. To show you guys the Camp Blood DVDs that are released, this is the whole series of what has been released on DVD. The rest of them were released on Blu-ray, and I will show you a video coming up in a week or so showing you the Blu-ray box that I picked up. But this is Camp Blood, Camp Blood 2, Camp Blood 3, Within the Woods, Camp Blood 4, Camp Blood 5, and Camp Blood 6. So let me put this stuff away and I will show you the quilt. Okay, so there is the quilt. This was an eBay purchase. It is a queen size, and I'm kind of showing you from afar to get it all in. And here comes the dog, of course, but it's really cool. It's got like the patchwork quilt type different photos on here. Some of them are pretty silly, but I love the colors. I like that big image in the middle. Watch out, Hannah, get down. That's the image of Jason from Part 3. And I'll just show you this real quick. I don't want to disturb them. They're getting ready for it. It's getting kind of late here. Just wanted to show you guys that cool comforter. So, all right, thank you guys for watching. Take care, and I will see you in the next video. Later.